Listening Library presents The League of Beastly Dreadfuls, Book 1, by Holly Grant. Read for you by Rosalyn Landor. Chapter 1. A Splendid Day for a Funeral. Anastasia's day began with a funeral, and it went downhill from there. Shivering beneath an umbrella, she wondered whether polka-dotted pyjamas and fuzzy bunny slippers were suitable funeral attire. The bunnies were perhaps a little too cheerful, goggling at the deceased with bright marble eyes. Well, at least the weather was properly miserable. It was drizzly and dour. The ground squelched with mud, and grey clouds curdled the sky. Anastasia regarded the scraggly November trees with satisfaction, counting 7 crows hunched in the bare branches. Yes, it was a splendid day for a funeral. Anastasia's father let out a sniffle, and she handed him the tissue box.
I just can't believe it, Mr. McCrumpet snuffled. It doesn't make sense. What a tragedy.
She's going to a better place, Anastasia told him, patting his arm.
The compost heap,
Mr. McCrumpet cried. Well, Anastasia said, it's a very nice compost heap. They bowed their heads in respectful silence. Rain gurgled in the drainpipes.
I suppose we should say a few words, Mr. McCrumpet sighed.
Fred, where's my breakfast? Sounded a nearby bellow. You know I'm ravenous when I wake up.
Coming, dear,
Mr. McCrumpet called, his shoulders drooping.
Dearly beloved, Anastasia said in her best funeral voice. We are gathered here to say goodbye to our friend Betty Lou.
Waffles!
Screeched the voice from the window. Mr. McCrumpet flinched.
Betty Lou was a great companion, Anastasia went on.
What does a woman have to do to get a simple Belgian waffle around here?
Mrs. McCrumpet hollered.
Betty Lou, we'll miss your hairy lips, Anastasia finished in a rush. Rest in peace. Is that enough, Dad? I think Mum's about to explode.
Besides, her bunny slippers were getting soggy.
Sorry about your plant.
Another loss,
Mr. McCrumpet blew his nose.
And Betty Lou was such a magnificent Venus flytrap specimen. Really first rate.
Until she stopped eating flies,
Anastasia pointed out.
Until she stopped eating flies,
Mr. McCrumpet echoed gloomily.
Do you expect the waffles to cook themselves?
Came the demand from the window.
And I want my happy forest maple syrup heated this time. Yesterday it was like eating cold glue.
For crumb's sake, can't a man mourn his Venus flytrap in peace?
Mr. McCrumpet muttered, throwing Betty Lou onto the odoriferous jumble of coffee grounds and eggshells before stomping back into the McCrumpet house. Anastasia followed behind, her bunnies squishing with each step. Mrs. McCrumpet wasn't the only one getting her breakfast late. Anastasia lathered her toast standing up, reflecting that she wouldn't have time to brush her teeth or comb her hair. That was just fine with her. She dunked her spoon back into the marmalade jar, and somehow, this sort of thing was always happening to Anastasia, a glob of orange goop catapulted into her eyes.
Ouch!
She tottered back from the table.
Careful!
Mr. McCrumpet looked up from the waffle griddle in alarm.
Look out for Muffy! Don't step on... Uh-oh. Too late.
Everyone knew 2 things about Muffy, the McCrumpet's pet guinea pig. 1, Muffy held a grudge. 2, Muffy was a revenge pooper, meaning Anastasia could expect a nasty surprise in one of her shoes, or perhaps on her pillow, within a day or so.
Is she okay?
Anastasia gasped, blinking through a haze of orange jam. Mr. McCrumpet was kneeling on the floor, patting the ruffled guinea pig.
She's offended, he said, and rightly so.
A honk outside signalled the school bus was at the curb.
I'm not even dressed,
Anastasia groaned.
Sorry, Muffster,
she apologised over her shoulder as she scrambled to grab whatever was rumpled at the top of the laundry hamper. No time for socks. She was still struggling into her hooded sweatshirt as she burst out the front door and lurched down the porch steps.
Wait! Wait for me!
Fortunately, the bus paused, its engine chugging. Unfortunately, Anastasia tripped and fell face first on the ground. Fortunately, a squidgy mud puddle cushioned her fall. Actually, that was pretty unfortunate too. Dirty water gushed from her nostrils as she twisted around and glared into the smiling plaster face of the garden gnome responsible for her fall. The front yard of the McCrumpet house was, you see, a veritable minefield of garden gnomes. Mrs. McCrumpet liked to order them from the shopping channel on TV.
Curse you, Winkles!
Anastasia peeled herself off the shabby McCrumpet lawn and limped to the bus. The door wheezed open.
Thanks for waiting, Mr. Butterfield, she panted, pulling her hood over her sopping braids.
The bus driver stared at her for a moment. He stuck his forefinger under the edge of his toupee and scratched his scalp.
Wasn't Halloween yesterday?
Anastasia rubbed the last bit of marmalade out of her eyes, peering down at yesterday's clothes she had scrounged from the hamper. Oh, crumbs! She waved her arms. Fuzzy brown flaps stretched from her sleeves to her side. She felt the seat of her pants and cringed. Yep, the droopy sock she had pinned to her jeans was still there. It looked like she was going to school as a flying squirrel again. Slogging to her seat, pretending not to hear the snickers sweeping around the bus, Anastasia reflected that her day couldn't possibly get any worse. As it happened, she was wrong. Within 42 minutes, calamity was to strike Anastasia McCrumpet. Chapter 2. Premonition of Doom. By this point, you're probably shaking your head and thinking, my gosh, poor Anastasia McCrumpet. Marmalade in her eyes and teetering on the brink of calamity. And revenge poo in her future too. This girl is tragic. However, Anastasia was not normally prone to calamity or disaster or anything that exciting. She was rather clumsy, I am sorry to say, and often embarrassed herself by falling down or spilling things. But her life was otherwise not marked by mishap. In general, Anastasia's existence was utterly uneventful. By all outward appearances, Anastasia was a completely average, almost 11-year-old girl. She had mousy brown hair, mousy brown eyes, and exactly 127 freckles. She dinged a triangle in the school band and always played a tree in the school plays. This isn't a very inspiring description, but it will have to do because it is true. If you want a hero with shiny hair and superb body odour, you'd better close this book and find something else to read. Anastasia was ordinary, and it wasn't just at Mooslick Elementary. Sometimes she felt like a tree in the school play of life. Anastasia lived in a shabby little town, in a shabby little house, with Mr. McCrumpet and Mrs. McCrumpet and Muffy, the guinea pig with anger management issues, whom you have already met. The McCrumpet household also included a variety of plants in various stages of dying. Despite Mr. McCrumpet's best efforts, most of his flora wound up on the compost heap, like Betty Lou, the Venus flytrap who went on a fatal hunger strike and whose funeral you have just attended. Aside from his failures with plants, Mr. McCrumpet had no hobbies or interests. He went quietly about his business selling vacuum cleaners door to door. In fact, he went quietly about everything he did. He even looked quiet, if you know what I mean. It was easy to forget he was in the room. His face was like wallpaper. Mrs. McCrumpet, on the other hand, was painfully conspicuous. You couldn't forget she was around, no matter how much you might have liked to do so. She was a big, bloated sea cucumber of a lady, and she was loud. She spent all her time clutching a hanky to her forehead and groaning and chugging cough syrup straight from the bottle. There is a kind of person who believes they are sick even when they are not, and Mrs. McCrumpet was just this kind of person. Now, some hypochondriacs are delightful, charming people, but Mrs. McCrumpet was neither delightful nor charming. She was bossy and bad-tempered. She stayed in bed all day long, and when she wanted something, she thumped the floor with a wooden handle of a broom. If that didn't bring Anastasia, or her father, scurrying upstairs within a couple of seconds, Mrs. McCrumpet started to holler. The longer
it took. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.